context.
Oh my god, it's given context!
It's okay, thank you. For way too long, the viewers of this channel have been left all alone in an endless world of problem-solving devoid of meaning. Problem-solving without... it hurts to say it. Context. A video without context is like a dog without a friend. It's like a cactus without rain. It's like a Model Y without a structural battery pack. Feel no fear, Captain Context is here. What you need to know to follow today's video is to play one single song on the Marble Machine X, you need to drop 3,500 marbles. If the reliability is 99.99%, that means that 1 out of 10,000 marbles would fail and destroy the Marble Machine X. With some luck, we could play one song, but if we tried to play two songs in a row, the machine would statistically break. Martin has realized that the Marble Machine X needs to be able to play 1,000 songs in a row without fail. This means that the reliability of the mechanism for the marble drop needs to be 99.99999%, which means that only one marble out of 10 million. Wait. 10 million marbles are allowed to fail. Hence, every part Martin makes has to work reliable 10 million times in a row without fail for the Marble Machine X to succeed. I am Captain Context, and this video has been marked with the seal of NCO approval and is now safe for you to watch. I made a mistake when I installed these links here. I deliberately chose to not countersink this connection here. So you can see this screw is sitting a little bit on top of the surface. So if you look closely right here, these two screws are touching. These two screws can hook up with each other by mistake, like that. And this must never happen. These channels have to be able to move back and forth individually. So under normal use, it almost never happens. But it's the almost never happen that is not good enough for the Marble Machine X. I need to fix this. Here you can see the screw head protruding above the surface. The reason I chose to not countersunk this is because I didn't want a lot of play in the fit between the screw and this hole. These are countersink, and the fit of the screw here is much looser. But later I realized that this sideways play doesn't affect the mechanical function at all. So my thought process was flawed, and I'm paying for that today. Now this spacer is stuck. So it turns out that this nut was easy to remove, but the problem is this brass spacer right here. That's loctited in and will rotate with a screw. When this subassembly is on the machine, the brass spacer is right inside that thing, so I can't grab it with a plier to hold it still. If you watch closely here, you can see that I actually countersunk this a little bit. If I actually would have countersunk this completely from the beginning, I wouldn't have to disassemble like 20 channels times 12 pieces. The day before this, I spent 7 hours putting these parts onto the machine, and now I'm taking them off already the day after. That's just how it is sometimes when you want to achieve the never fail in 1 in 10 million marble drop reliability. Imagine if I would just have countersunk this from the beginning. well, let's countersink them. Thank you. not identical. They are kind of mirrored. So half of the parts I can prepare here on the bench. The other half I need to prepare on the machine itself. So now for some more repetitive work, but I'm at a high spirit here because I'm on my way of actually solving this problem. It feels great. It goes kind of slow, but I'm very careful with each little screw. I saw a video with firefighters walking around when putting out a fire, and people were complaining in the comment section. And then I learned that walking is something firefighters learn, because when they walk, they make less mistakes and put out the fire faster. Kind of cool. All the countersinks looks great. All that remains is now cutting these bolts that are still sticking out. I'm done remounting all this and do it right. I'm gonna show you how clean we can make this look now. This microphone stand looks so overkill, but if you put headphones on, you can listen to this ratchet. Oh yeah. Let's now see if this lid will fit in. Felt is on the backside here, will rest against all these pieces. Ooh. I love that. So these registrators are so much smoother, so much less friction in here than it was with all the old parts. And I mean, it looks reliable. It gives you confidence, doesn't it? To put all this together, I needed 14 custom length bolts. And I wanted to show you two different techniques to repair a thread after cutting a bolt. I used to use the technique of putting a nut on the bolt, then cutting it, and then unscrewing the nut, having the nut repairing the thread. That kind of works sometimes, but sometimes not. In this case, it didn't work at all. So what I found is a much faster and more reliable technique that works every time is to just make a simple chamfer of the cut edge. If you don't have a machine, you can use sandpaper or a file. As long as you create a chamfer on your bolt, the nut will screw on perfectly. Works every time. Bring out the headphones. I really like how this looks. It looks so chunky and stable. I'm thrilled that I know that nothing can get caught in here. Really, really happy. You just seen me correct a simple mistake, and maybe it wasn't so riveting, but in the context of things, all these things are what makes the marble machine or breaks it. I'm really happy how this turned out and to be done with it. Next episode, I think I'm going to assemble this sub-assembly to the machine. Huge thanks to all the Wintergatan patrons and YouTube members and everyone following this crazy build series. We're going to find out if this machine is a masterpiece or if it's a sunken cost fallacy in the end. This sub-assembly is a masterpiece though, and I will assemble this onto the machine in the next episode. See you then. Have a really nice day, everyone. Bye.